The Archer Theory, a theory of filmmaking in which the director is viewed as the major creative force in a motion picture. Arising in France in the late 1940s, the Archer Theory, as it was dubbed by the American film critic Andrew Saris, was an outgrowth of the cinematic theories of André Bazin and Alexandre Ostrog, a foundation stone of the French cinematic movement known as Nouvelle Vague or New Wave. In this comparative study, I'm going to be focusing on two movies created by Alejandro González Iñárritu, a film director that directed both Amores Perros in 2000 and Beautiful in 2010. The topic of this comparative study will be the representation of anti-hero inner catch conflict through cinematography and mise-en-scene. Recurring themes through the use of powerful shot composition representing Alejandro González Iñárritu as an archer. Drama films are serious presentations of or stories with settings or life situations that portray realistic characters in conflict with either themselves, others, or forces of nature. A dramatic film shows us human beings at their best, their worst, and everything in between. Each of the type of subject matter themselves have various kinds of dramatic plots. Dramatic films are probably the largest film genre because they include a broad spectrum of films. Another closely related film genre is the horror film genre. Thriller and suspense films are virtually synonymous and interchangeable categorizations. They are types of films known to promote intense excitement, suspense, and high level of anticipation, ultra-heightened expectation, uncertainty, anxiety, and nerve-wracking tension. The acclaimed master of suspense is Alfred Hitchcock. Spy films may be considered a type of thriller-slash-suspense film. Amores Perros is a drama thriller broken into three storylines in which the film are interconnected, showing how all the principal characters are related to one another by chance. This movie was released the 16th of June of the 2000s in Mexico and is set in Mexico City, showing the harsh reality of living in this big city during these times. The movie had a budget of around $2.4 million and had a box office of $20.9 million, making Iñárritu's introduction to the film industry as director of movies a very successful one. Beautiful is a film released in the 22nd of October of 2010, this film being classified as a drama romance. A romance being classified as a romantic affectionate involvement of the main characters, usually a leading man or and lady, and the journey that their love takes through the courtship or marriage. Romance films make the love story the main plot focus. The movie had a budget of around $35 million, already a lot more than the low-budget film Amores Perros, which was already set as Amores Perros, only received $2.4 million. Different from Amores Perros, Beautiful did relatively worse, as it wasn't able to make back its budget, after having made only $24.7 million for the box office. Both these films are affected by the context of the director Iñárritu, as he is a Mexican film director for Mexico City itself, a place in Mexico that celebrates the Day of the Dead the most. The Day of the Dead being a celebration in which everyone, including friends and family, comes together to celebrate, pray, and respect the memory of a dead loved one. Latin American and Hispanic culture places a great value in family. Hispanics and Latin Americans tend to have very large, close-knit families. It is not uncommon for these generations to live in the same household or nearby each other. Grandparents typically play an important role in their grandchildren's upbringing. The emphasis on the well-being of the family makes Hispanic and Latin Americans very group-oriented, with family gatherings being a commonplace. These playing a role, once again, in the two movies, since they are both set in Latin American and Hispanic areas like Mexico and Barcelona themselves. Iñárritu's constant impact on his films due to his cultural background shows him as an archer. The anti-hero. An anti-hero is a central character in a story, film, or drama who lacks conventional heroic attributes. Iñárritu portrays these sorts of characters in Amores Perros as Octavio, Daniel, and El Chivo, and in Beautiful in the way of Usval. Octavio is said to be the heroic figure of his brother's wife, Susana, who gets beaten and abused by her husband. Octavio wants to help the damsel in distress, yet from the beginning, we see him contradicting himself, just like an anti-hero would, since after all, he fell in love with his own brother's wife, and that's quite unethical. Iñárritu showcases Octavio's intentions throughout the entire film, as every time we see both Octavio and Susana together, the camera puts Octavio as the focus while Susana is merely there to give conversation. In the first scene, he stands up to her, for example, we see Susana is completely powerless since she gives most of her back to the camera, and Octavio is the main focus. As the scene progresses, there start to be extreme close-ups aimed at Octavio, once his older brother, Susana's husband, arrives and starts talking in a bad way to Susana. These close-ups focus on Susana's husband and Octavio as they start having turmoil because of Octavio covering up for Susana. The same anti-hero qualities can be seen in Urbal, as he is a coward and does not and cannot own up to his own decisions and the problems that they cause. For example, the scene where he returns to the factory where all the Chinese immigrants left. But before the scene, Urbal had bought some sheep heaters in order to warm up the area as it gets very cold at night. In the scene, we see that as Urbal realizes that his good deed turned into a murder of all these Chinese workers, he starts getting out anxious and desperate, as he does not accept what he has done and cannot let it go. The feeling of his desperation is amplified by Iñárritu's and Roberto Prieto's, the cinematographer, camera work. We see from the start a close-up of his face as he is desperately and aggressively trying to figure out what happened. As Urbal is walking down the stairs, the camera follows him with a slight upward tilt to show his full body for both his expression and pace, both showing his anxiousness. Once he arrives at the basement, where all the immigrants slept, we see a close-up of his face which is tilting downwards, giving the idea he feels down and surprised, and as he moves through the corpses, the camera follows him and his line of sight, allowing us to feel like we are Urbal in this pivotal scene. When he sees the only survivor, once again, we go into his line of sight, which ends with a very powerful shot of the face of the only survivor. The recurring use of anti-heroes showing Iñárritu as an archer, just as Octavio unethically loving his brother's wife, and Urbal not wanting to face the outcomes of his actions. Inner character conflict. Iñárritu and Arriaga work together to create a great sense of emotion inside each character and often leading to inner turmoil of the character. This we can see from how Urbal in Beautiful fights himself and his inner demons, as he has the ability to talk to the dead. We see this happening throughout the film as we see recurring close-ups of Urbal's face with Iñárritu placing the blurry soul of a dead person in the room. We see the same inner turmoil when we go to El Chivo. He no longer likes the life of a beggar slash hitman and now wants to return to his normal life as a professor in a university and be able to live with his daughter and wife. We see him struggling with himself when we see the medium shot of his room with him laying down with his dogs as we zoom into his face as he grabs his broken glasses to look at the picture of his daughter. We are shown this same feeling of sorrow, disillusionment and struggling with oneself's thoughts every time we get to the point of a character story in which they lose everything, this being like Octavio after the car crash and in his brother's funeral. He asks one last thing to Susana, which is for her to escape with him. We are taken on a trip by Iñárritu across Octavio's mixed and troubled feelings along the scene, once again getting Octavio's close-ups to fully embrace us as the audience in Octavio's emotions, which along with his expression and tone we can tell is the feeling of being lost and betrayed. As the scene moves on and Susana leaves the room, the camera pans out, allowing us to see the crippling Octavio still chasing his brother's wife, even after his death. Once we move to the conversation between Susana and Octavio, we see the close-up of both taken in a long shot in which the one as the focus of the camera being Susana and not Octavio as he used to. This showing Octavio as he loses his power and confidence. At the end of the scene, we see Octavio becoming aggressive with his words, once again allowing us to appreciate his mixed feelings after having lost his money, Susana, and his best friend and dog. The recurring theme of inner turmoil and conflict being one preferred by Iñárritu, utilized by him to portray most of his characters. As a conclusion, we see Iñárritu's evolution as a filmmaker all the way from the start of his film career with Amores Perros to Beautiful, his fourth film. He changed some of his characteristics, like the preferred three-story arc development, on his films, yet he does keep most of his essence, as are the main ideas that make up the typical Iñárritu film. He keeps the idea of the theme of death in his films, darkness, and the use of anti-hero type characters, and Iñárritu utilizes the same cinematographer, in turn keeping the style of taking powerful emotional packed shots of all his different characters. All of these features spoken about during this comparative study are what effectively showcases Alfonso González Iñárritu as a film auteur.